I'm Liz Tessone, and welcome to the Caring Matters podcast. I'm here today with Tipa Snow. We're on the campus of Xavier University, where she's spent the day teaching. She's going to be doing more teaching tonight and more teaching tomorrow. So the woman is highly used here at Xavier University. And we are lucky enough to sit with Tipa today to talk to caregivers about dementia. Tipa is a national expert on caregiving for patients with dementia. And so what she first is going to talk to us about is what the difference is, or is there a difference between dementia and Alzheimer's, because I know people are quite confused on that. So first, let's address that one.
Sure. Well, it's really important to know that dementia and Alzheimer's are not the same thing. Dementia is a great big umbrella term. It covers probably 75 up to 90 different variation causes and forms. Now, when we say somebody has dementia, what we're saying, it's not actually a diagnosis. Now, I know that's a surprise for many people, because when you went to the doctor, they said, well, she has some form of dementia, and it's probably Alzheimer's, but we're not going to push it. It doesn't really matter. Yeah, it does. Because dementia means that the person has at least two parts of their brain that are dying. It means that it's a condition that we can't fix. We can't make it go away. We can't cure it. We can't even stop it. And it also means it's going to get worse. So we know that it's a progressive illness when we say it's a dementia, if it's really been worked up. And then the last thing we know is that it's terminal. And I will tell you, most folks who think somebody has dementia, that is not what they're thinking. The words they think, dementia, Alzheimer's, memory problems. But it's not memory problems, it's brain failure. And I think that's a critical difference, that if we could get our heads around that, it would help us as caregivers. So when somebody has Alzheimer's, we've got a great big umbrella of dementia. Under that umbrella are different boxes, different causes and types of dementia. And Alzheimer's is the most common. But 10 years ago, we were saying it was probably 80 to 90% of all dementias. Our current thinking is probably it's 50 to 60% of all dementias. So it's not the be-all and end-all that we thought it was.
Right.
With Alzheimer's, there is a very solid pattern of development. They will lose immediate recall, then they'll have problems with short-term memory, and they'll start having difficulty with spatial recognition. So where am I? Landmarks, and knowing what's going on in their life in that moment. But the old memories are fine. At first. Mm-hmm. They also start to have some difficulty with finding the thing they want to say. You know, you know what I mean. You put it in a sentence. Well, now I just showed you, not only do I have trouble with finding words, but my control over myself is fading a little bit. I'm yelling at my daughter. I mean, I emotionally wouldn't have done that, but I'm having some problem with my front of my brain, my control center. Mm. And I can't get the thing to come out, the word, and I lose nouns first. And that's a typical progression pattern with Alzheimer's. Now, another type of dementia, however, that's very common is vascular. It's very different. It doesn't necessarily start with any particular kind of memory problem. It could actually start more with a problem with vision, or a problem with movement, or a problem with thinking, or judgment, or behavior, or emotion. Because vascular dementia is a blood supply problem to the brain. It's not actually a formal brain disease. Mm. But if your brain doesn't get oxygen and nourishment, it doesn't work very well. Mm. And over time, you run the risk that those brain cells actually die. And so with vascular dementia, if you've ever had a stroke, or you've had a heart attack, or you've had heart surgery, or you've had problems with your breathing like COPD, or you have congestive heart failure, or you have hypertension that's poorly managed, or diabetes that's poorly managed, your risk of getting vascular dementia goes up. The older you get, it gets worse. And the bad news is you can have both. And so it's called mixed picture. So as a family member, you want to know what's going on here. And you don't want to be satisfied with, well, dementia. Because dementia is a syndrome, not a diagnosis.
Mm. Okay, so it's really important for a family member, if they're beginning to recognize some changes in...
Yeah, especially in the early stages, because it's very different. And let's say with Alzheimer's, for instance, the average length of time someone will show symptoms is about 8 to 12 years, from first symptom to end of life. With vascular, 3 to 30.
Oh, big difference.
Now, does that matter as a caregiver? You better believe it. In addition, I don't know what's coming next with vascular. They can stay the same for a long time and have sudden changes and then actually bounce back and look better. So you're looking at everybody else around and going, well, you know, I don't know that it's dementia, because see, they're not getting worse like these other folks are. That's because they don't have Alzheimer's, they have vascular. But there are about 75 to 90 different other ones. So there's Lewy body dementia, there's dementia that comes with Parkinson's, there's frontal lobe dementia, there's temporal lobe language dementias, primary progressive aphasia, there's Creutzfeldt-Jakob's disease, there's Huntington's chorea. So in other words, you do want to know, especially early on, because it's going to make it so much better for planning and for deciding, well, if they can still do this, then we'll plan for this. If they can't do this, then we've got that. And the earlier we can identify this, the better for a caregiver's sake, because you know what you're looking at.
Yeah.
And what to put in place.
So you've got to find a doctor who's willing to be make a very definitive diagnosis when it comes to the type of dementia.
Yeah, and you also want a doctor who's going to be able to work with you as a caregiver.
Okay.
They've got to recognize the need to have a three-legged stool. The person with the condition, them, the skilled professional, but the person who's also going to help manage life. And we've got to get those pieces together before we get started. So what does that mean? Well, my recommendation is, whether you need to or not, if you're a caregiver, you don't even think you've got dementia, still get a healthcare power of attorney. Because what you want to make sure is you always have the ability and the right to get information from the physician when you're trying to help the person you care about. Because with dementia, I may or may not recognize the need to share information with you, and I may or may not be able to get information accurately from one place to the other. So the doctor may be saying to me, I'm a little concerned about your blood pressure. I think it's dropping too low, and I want you to switch out. You're doing fine, but I do want to drop that blood pressure medicine down to half a pill. Well, I didn't get all that. And so I come out saying, oh, he says I'm good, but I should take an extra half a pill for my blood pressure. So now I start to take a pill and a half rather than cut it in half. You, the caregiver, going, well, why is he asking her to do that? Without the healthcare power of attorney, you may or may not be able to call and find out.
So that's critical.
Oh, yeah. You've got to have it to be effective. And you've got to have a doctor who's going to open up and talk with you about the concerns. And it may need to be with me not present. Not because you don't care about me, but when I'm present, what do you need to know all that? You don't need to tell him that. And we get into an argument in front of him, instead of deal with the issue, because I'm having a hard time coping and I don't even understand why you're helping when I know what I'm doing. But because the issue is the front of my brain and my impulse control, I don't know what I'm doing, but I think I do.
You don't know that you don't know.
Exactly. And a lot of people with Alzheimer's particularly, and other forms of dementia, don't know that they don't know. They think they're fine. So that makes it really hard on a caregiver.
Yeah.
So you've got to learn the art of caregiving with dementia.
Right.
Whatever type it is. But knowing what type matters.
Okay. So it's really important that a caregiver find a good diagnostician.
Thank you. There you go. You had the right word.
Yeah.
So we're good. We're good.
Okay. So that they have a clear diagnosis, because a lot of people just throw those words out. Alzheimer's,
absolutely,
dementia.
Well, you know she's 85. I mean, that's probably the one of those comments. Well, you know she's 85. So what? Your brain still works right unless there's a disease process. And things that look like dementia sometimes aren't. That's critical. Because it could be depression. It could be a delirium from an illness like a urinary tract infection. It could be too many medicines. It could be medicine interactions. It could be another condition like diabetes that snuck up on you. It could be pain medications that you're taking and is affecting your thinking. It could be nighttime sleep aids like Tylenol PM with Benadryl, that you took just fine when you were in your 50s, but now that you're 75, it's affecting your thinking. So there's a lot to this.
Or just the combination of
a lot
of...
Or the combo. Yeah, you get on a lot of med side effects. So we need to get smarter about making sure the person who's helping us professionally is the best person for both the person with dementia, but also for the caregiver.
Very good. I think what I'm going to do is stop us here,
okay,
and then in our next podcast is really go into kind of what we can do as caregivers when we are with our loved one who keeps asking the same question or
whatever. Oh, my favorite topics.
Okay. Very good. So thank you, Tipa, this podcast. And please check out our sponsors. And we'll be right back because we're going to record a second one. I'm Liz Tessone, and always remember, caring matters.